So Russell Wilson is now going to be taking on the Green Bay Packers and the Green Bay Packers defense, and I think it could be a very interesting matchup. One thing that I think has really hurt the Seahawks, and a reason why I think that they're a much worse team now than they were when it started the year, is just the running game. As much as I personally love Marshawn Lynch, I mean, he isn't Chris Carson at this point in his career, I don't think. Although, you know, not terrible, but the running game as a whole has taken a huge hit with the injuries they've had at the halfback position. And so at this point, really, a lot of the work has to go on Russell Wilson's shoulders. Russell Wilson has to be the guy who is going to be making plays, and not just Wilson, but the wide receivers, DK Metcalf, especially, and also Tyler Lockett. Those two guys are going to have to be making plays, which is difficult when opposing teams know that that's what's going to be happening. They know that they're probably not going to run the ball, there's going to be a lot of passing plays, and so therefore, you can play a lot of man coverage. Man coverage is obviously a lot more effective when you are playing against a team like the Seattle Seahawks, who they like to throw the ball a lot. And also with rookie receivers like Lockett and DK Metcalf, you know, they're good receivers and they can get in gaps in coverage if you're playing zone coverage. So against man, it just does make things easier. Like, watch, on a play like this, it's against the San Francisco 49ers, and they're going to be playing a cover one blitz right now. The San Francisco 49ers are. And so for Metcalf, he's going to be running that route right there. Just a slant route over the middle. Absolutely just a perfect route against this type of coverage. It's what you want against man. There's a quick cut over the middle, but keep in mind, if you play this one right, you can actually still definitely have some success, and the San Francisco 49ers are going to play this one right. Watch what Metcalf's inside man Witherspoon is going to do here. Watch how at first he's playing a little bit further back, so if Metcalf is running deep, he can then follow him deep. But now at this point, he looks at Metcalf and sees that Metcalf is cutting, and so he's going to break in and make a play. Metcalf doesn't make a ton of double moves, so that's how he was able to break it up, know that he wasn't going to be making a double move of some sort. He was patient, broke in. And even if Metcalf was going to be making a move and was going to cut back up to try to run deep, you have enough space that you could then continue running deep with him, and you at least would have a chance in that situation, and then obviously if you break in, then you can knock the ball away. So you have to play aggressive against a guy like Metcalf, and that's what Green Bay will probably want to do. Now for Seattle, there is one bright side with knowing that a lot of teams are going to be playing a lot of man coverage, because that is the type of coverage that's best to beat you, especially like a single safety deep. Maybe you could blitz or just have a cover one whole concept where there's someone in the middle of the field, which is actually what Philadelphia is going to be running on this play. But if you know that a lot of those plays are coming, you can design routes designed to beat this coverage. And that's what Seattle's going to do on this play, where they have DK Metcalf once again running a go route. This is going to give you a chance right now, because this is a great route to beat this coverage. It is going to be a one-on-one matchup, and all Metcalf has to do is win his one-on-one matchup. Seems pretty simple, right? Well, kind of. But the problem is, Jalen Mills here, he knows that the one way he could get beat is with a go route. He knows anything cutting over the middle, he's okay, because he does have some help in that direction, so he doesn't have to worry too much about that. So right when the ball snapped, notice how he pretty instantly just bails. He also doesn't totally ignore the middle of the field. He is doing a good job of staying closer to the middle of the field than Metcalf is, but he also is doing a good job of staying deep enough that if it is a go route, now there's going to be a very small window for this ball to be complete too. But notice I did not say there is no window, and that is because on these types of plays, you are going to have a chance if you're an offense. You have to make a pretty good throw, but there is still a window where Wilson can try to make these throws. However, this time Wilson just misses it, and also a slight correction here. That's actually Ricardo Lockett, not Metcalf. Not really sure why I thought it was Metcalf, but moving on. It's just really tough to make those types of throws, and also Lockett maybe could have ran a slightly better route. Maybe if that was Metcalf like I thought, then he would be able to actually run that route a little bit better and make the grab. But the idea is you're forcing your opponents to be great, and that's what you want to do against a guy like Russell Wilson. Russell Wilson is great, and he will make some great throws. And you just got to say, you know what? When you make a great throw, that's fine. We'll give you those yards, but we're not going to let you do anything other than be great to beat us. If you're good, that's not going to be enough. That has to be the mindset for Green Bay. But there's also one other key thing that Seattle will probably be doing a lot against Green Bay. I expect a lot of these types of things, where, once again, it's going to be a cover one hole concept that they're going up against. But look at the routes that the Seattle Seahawks receivers are going to be running. There's a lot of crossing routes, so that's the first thing you'll notice. A lot of things over the middle, and that's great against man coverage, because they're saying, wait a second, Philadelphia is almost exclusively running man coverage, so let's try to run some routes that are designed to beat man coverage. That last one was one that had a chance. This one is another one that has a chance. Really, at the end of that route right there, right when that receiver gets to right there, that's when potentially there could be a window where Wilson could make the throw. Because he is going to have to wait until after he gets past in the middle of the field, since there will be an eagle in that area. But once he gets past there, he could get open, especially because there will be somewhat of a pick play. Like, watch, right when the ball is snapped, notice what's going on right there. So the Seattle receiver who's running up to the top half of the screen is doing a pretty good job of staying where he has to be. He's running his route in the perfect spot, so that way the assigned defender who's in charge of covering the receiver running to the bottom half of the screen, he's going to sort of have a logjam right there, and he won't be able to get through cleanly. And because of that, Metcalf got it right this time, is able to make the catch and even run for a ton more yards until he goes out of bounds. So that's kind of what I expect the Seahawks to be doing a good amount of. Granted, those plays are not guaranteed to work either, and if you run too much, then opposing defenders can sort of catch on, and they can start switching when you do things like that, which would be two defenders basically switch assignments mid-play, which is risky if somebody screws it up, but if nobody screws it up, it can work out really well. If you do it a lot, then guys can get good at it in a hurry, so that's something you could worry about, but I definitely suspect Seattle to be doing this to some degree. Especially because this is a way you can beat the Green Bay Packers defense. I do suspect that Green Bay will be playing a lot of man coverage. I mean, we saw how well that worked when Philadelphia did it. I know Philadelphia lost, but they held the Seahawks to 17 points, even with the few big plays that the Seattle Seahawks receivers had. I mean, that's why I thought the Seahawks were going to lose that game, because I didn't think their offense was going to be able to get much done without a good running game. They didn't get much done. I thought the Eagles' offense would do a little bit more, but I do think that the Seattle offense does match up better against this Green Bay defense. One guy, actually the guy I'm going to talk about on defense, is going to be Jair Alexander. He is the guy. He is the one that basically is going to be holding this whole thing together, I think. Like, watch him go up against basically the exact same play I talked about, where it's cover one hole, there's going to be two receivers running those routes right there. Alexander is in charge of covering one of those receivers. And take a look at what happens right when this ball is snapped. If you notice, his assigned man gets a definite opening right here. So, similar problem to the one I just talked about. You know, there's that opening. And at this point, if there's a window here, and it's someone like Russell Wilson throwing the ball, you have no choice but to just say, you know what, I'm going to make the tackle, give you 5 to 6 yards, whatever, we'll go on to the next play. The Seahawks don't really have much of a running game anyways, so moving the ball methodically down the field isn't going to do too much to them as it would to other teams. So you have to be patient here and make the tackle, but he's just not. He's going to reach out, go for the ball, and misses. And listen, I get it. That's part of Alexander's game. He plays aggressive. It results in a lot of good things happening. It results in a lot of bad things happening. That time a bad thing happened, on other plays, good things will happen. But that is a problem, in my opinion, and a bit of a worry when you have a Seattle defense that likes to sort of prey on corners being aggressive, so to speak. That being said, for every one of those, there's 5 of these, where once again, it's going to be a one-on-one matchup, and Alexander is going up against a slant route, but watch how patient he is on this one. He totally lets his assigned man come to him, and at this point, you have no choice if you're that Giants receiver. He's just going to try to create some contact, but that's not really going to work out too well. Jones kind of has no choice but to try to throw it to his direction anyways, but it's just not going to work out. Alexander is so good at breaking on the ball. He's so good at finishing plays. That's one of the things I really like about him and how he's able to finish there. And that could definitely come into play. You know, Seattle, they do like to run some slant routes, and Alexander can definitely try to break those up. So I do think that there is some good and some bad with Alexander. And I think that he is going to be the key piece of the puzzle, probably an entire game, honestly. It does seem like when you preview these games, it almost turns into a puzzle, and you figure out the one piece that they're all connected to. And I guess it's not really a puzzle, but if I made a weird puzzle about football, that's how I would make it. This makes no sense. My analogies are not that great. You know, listen to Strong Opinion Sports if you want some good analogies. I don't do that. But yeah, I really do think that this team could be really interesting to watch. This game could be really interesting to watch. And I think that the Packers will probably win, but it should be fun, I think. The Packers were the one team I predicted actually not making it to the championship round that had a bye, but I think that now that the Saints are out, and now that they're playing Seattle as opposed to playing New Orleans, I've changed my opinion. I do think that they will probably win this game. I think it'll probably be the 49ers and the Packers in the NFC Championship. I know that's kind of a boring take, but that's what I think will happen. I think, listen, this team won 13 games for a reason. Maybe they're not the most complete team ever. Maybe they're not the best 13-3 team we've ever seen, but they're still 13-3. And listen, Seattle's no slouch. I'm not going to count them out. It should be a fun game. Let me know, who do you think is going to win in the comments below? Weird things always seem to happen when these two teams play each other, so should be fun to watch. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And as always, thanks for watching.